Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to create interesting photo slideshows in Keynote. So I'm using Keynote version 6 here, and one of the great things about Keynote is you can use it to create slideshows that are better than things you might typically see using a video editing tool like iMovie or just using the simple slideshow tool in iPhoto. Because basically, a Keynote presentation is a slideshow, so all you need to do is add a bunch of images. I've got a presentation here, the default opening screen, and I'm going to go into Media, into Photos, and select a bunch of photos here. And you can just select one and it will fill a slide. But better than that, if you want to add a whole bunch of photos, what you could do is go into the Finder and find these photos as files. I'm going to just select some pics here, and got a whole bunch of them. And I'm going to grab all of these. I'm going to drag them into the left area here as slides. And what it's going to do is it's going to create slides that basically are pre-populated with the photos taking up the entire screen. So we can shrink this down and see. And I've just created an instant slideshow. A lot easier than adding each one individually. I can also, as I'm selecting in the left here, do Command A to select all of these slides here. And I can add transitions for all of them. So let's do an effect here and just do, say, let's do clothesline because it's fun. And I've just added it for all of these slides here. So I can now play the presentation and I've got animations for all the slides without having to go and add one individually for each one. And I could, of course, go into each one and customize which which transition I use or don't use a transition. So there's a lot of different things that I could do on a per slide basis. I'm just trying to make it as simple as possible. But because this is a presentation and not a slideshow, I can add all the other things that I want to add. So for instance, if I wanted to add some text here, I can add a text box and caption this and put this in here and just do all the normal things I would do to text to make it stand out and change its size and such. So it's very easy. You can customize with anything you want. I can even add shapes to it. So I can add an arrow. I could add a circle like here and change the border to something. Change the fill to nothing. To circle something. Let's change this circle here, the border here, to a better color, like that. So all sorts of things you can just draw on each individual slide. Plus you can create things between slides. So I could add a slide between this here and put some text. So I interject some text in between each of these. I could even duplicate a slide. Let's go into here and duplicate it and then create a transition between it where maybe I zoom in on an element of the slide that I want. Like that. So I can show the same image twice very easily. Like that. Put a nice transition between them. So everything's at your disposal. Everything that you can use in the presentation you can use here. So you can start off by creating a basic slideshow with just dumping a bunch of pictures into the thumbnails on the left. And then you can add transitions, add interjections, add commentary and annotation to each of these slides. And then you could continue to add more. Rearrange things very easily. Just drag and drop in there. So you have just a ton of ability to create all sorts of different things in slideshows. And you see how fast I'm doing this, how fast I built all of this stuff here live in this video. So imagine what you can do if you just spent a little bit of time with the right set of photos creating a really killer slideshow. But that's not all, because you could also go to Setup here and go to Audio and record your voice narrating this slideshow. Or not even record your voice, because any recording you do, you're going to not only record your voice, but you're going to record the timing between each slide. And here I've got the record buttons at the bottom, so I can record and it's going to grab my voice here which I'm just going to talk over, but it's also going to record this timing here for each individual slide. So I can kind of linger on a slide and talk about it, or quickly advance from one to the next without much hesitation like that. And then when I'm done, I hit that button again and close this, and I've got the recording. Now I can export in two different ways. I can export as a video using either a self-playing movie, so I can say, look, every slide, 5 seconds, go to next build after 2 seconds, set the format, or I can say use that recorded timing and the audio I used and export it out. So I can, you know, if one slide's 10 seconds and the next slide is 3 seconds, it's going to use all of that, and then I'll end up with a custom slideshow that's kind of narrated or at least timed by me. And then of course, in addition, you could also add audio and audio soundtrack here in this. So when you export it as video, you'll get, you know, say a music background as well as your voice recorded. You also have some other export options because you have the ability to export as HTML. And this will create a set of HTML documents that will then allow you to upload it to a website. So I'll just do this, create a slides, and it's going to export it out. So the result here is really interesting. Here's what it created, that slides folder. I click on it, grab my voice, and it's actually playing audio and showing the slides, but it's not video. It's actually dynamic HTML, so no videos being played, no special plugins are needed. It's just basically showing images and playing an audio file back there, and it should work on a wide variety of machines and browsers. So as an alternative to that style of HTML, I'm going to clear out the recording. And so now there's really no recording, no record timing in there. It's just all the manual advance for a slideshow. So when I export HTML, I'm going to get something a little different. And I'm going to save this as slides 2 and export it out. And now I've got a set here in slides 2 that behaves completely differently. It comes up and I actually have to manually advance it by clicking on the image. But notice how it does the transition. And again, this is not a plugin. This is just dynamic HTML here. You can even use the arrow keys, at least the right arrow key, to go forward. So you have a more of a normal slideshow.